Okay, we are barreling towards the end of an admittedly somewhat trying section. Only one substitution left to present. So the third substitution is that if you see this square root, you might consider letting x be a tangent. And this is the triangle we are imagining when we do this substitution. We are going to go rogue with our example, though. We've kept trying to emphasize that these are only guidelines. What better way to emphasize that than to actually do an example where the guideline doesn't work? Therefore, the integral we compute will be 1 divided by 1 plus x squared squared. No square root to be found. But lacking anything else to do, this doesn't seem to be a u substitution or integration by parts. We say to ourselves, well, we might not have the square root, but we do have the a squared plus the x squared. Let's go ahead and see what happens if we do let x be the tangent. So a is 1 here. I'm going to go ahead and make that change in the triangle as well. dx is the secant squared theta d theta. And let's take this and plug it in and see if it gets us anywhere. So 1 divided by 1 plus the tangent squared squared times the secant squared theta d theta. And here's where all the problems we did, where we used the Pythagorean identity, stand us in good stead. When we used the Pythagorean identity, it was for the concrete purpose of getting rid of a square root. Here we don't have a square root, but we'll still use the trigonometric identity here. Remember the Pythagorean identity, the sine squared plus the cosine squared equals 1. We want a 1 plus a tangent squared, If we divide both sides by the cosine squared, the sine over the cosine is the tangent. The cosine over the cosine is 1. And we get a secant squared theta. Let us see. That looks hopeful because we also have a secant up here in the numerator. So it looks like we could realistically expect some cancellation to occur. The secant squared theta. When we take the secant squared and square it, we get to the secant to the fourth, or 1 divided by the secant squared theta. Since the secant is 1 divided by the cosine, this is the cosine squared theta. So, relax, take a deep breath. We still have a ways to go. Good news, bad news. The good news is that we do know how to take this integral using trigonometric identities. The bad news is we have an even power here. Still, it's not that bad since we don't also have even powers of the sine. And since the cosine is only being squared, not raised to the fourth or anything like that, we get, this will give us a 1/2. It's 1 plus the cosine of 2 theta over 2. I'm going to pull that over 2 straight out and get 1 plus the cosine of 2 theta d theta. Good news so far. This is easy to anti-differentiate, and this is easy to anti-differentiate. The antiderivative of 1 is theta. The antiderivative of this is 1/2 the sine of 2 theta. Unfortunately, we're still a little ways from the end. At this point, we need to go from theta back to x. Well, this is easy. This is straightforward. If x equals 1 times the tangent of theta, then the arc tangent of x equals theta. It's this sign that gives us an issue. Previously, when we've got to this point and had things like this, we went to the right triangle and just used right triangle trigonometry in a very straightforward way. But that 2 theta, rather than the theta we have here, messes things up. And there is one final trick we must perform. One half the sine of 2 theta. The sine of 2 theta is 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta. That would not be a bad identity to have memorized if you don't already. So 1 half times 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta. The 1 half and the 2 cancel. And now that we have the sine of theta, the cosine of theta, instead of 2 theta, we can look these up. The sine of theta is the opposite side over the hypotenuse. The cosine of theta is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. In other words, 1 over this square root times x over this square root. The square root times the square root is the function. And we find that this is x divided by 1 plus x squared. And now let's write the answer down cleanly. 1 half the arctangent plus this fraction plus our constant of integration. And that is trigonometric substitution.